Mark, thank you so much for talking to us. Obviously, we saw you basically on the day that you announced your retirement. How's your journey been since then, for only 4 months ago?
There's been a lot of up and downs. Like, everything has been going according to plan, but obviously with an operation like that, it brings you back to square one again. Like, I lost all my fitness, you lose loads of weight, and like I said, physically it drains you. And then, like I said, the one thing that I probably underestimated the most was the mental side of it. That's probably been the toughest part of the whole process so far.
How bad has been your bad days? Because obviously you're recovering from a major operation. Like you said, physically you're probably prepared for that. Mentally, I know that you've had some really dark days. Talk to me about those.
It's been tough, really, because, like I said, I have prepared myself, understanding like that the days that are good are going to be really good, but I knew physically I was going to be drained, and I knew, like, obviously, maybe the thought of, how can I put it, maybe the thought of being not physically right and having to retire all at the same time, like missing out on the game that I've loved for the last 10 years of my whole life, that mentally, like, the dark days have been tough, because sometimes I could just be sitting on the sofa and something will just come over me. And like I said, I never understood what a panic attack was, and until once, a couple of weeks when I got out of hospital, I remember sitting there and I ended up having this panic attack. At the time, I didn't realise what it was, because I started, like, my heart was racing for no apparent reason. And your first thought is, oh my God, the valve must be not working again. Something's not going right. And as I've said, I had to call an ambulance, and I had to go into hospital to find out that everything is fine. And so, just to reassure my own mind again, and the one thing that I've probably needed through all of this is a lot more reassurance than I've ever needed before. And I think that's something that has never been me, but I've started to slowly see that the reassurance has been great, but actually speaking to people and asking the questions that are on my mind instead of just trying to answer them myself, I'm finding myself a lot easier and handling it a lot better.
That's going to be one of my questions, is that especially with men, there's a stigma around talking about feelings. We know that suicide is one of the biggest killer of young men. Has it helped talking to people?
Yeah, it's been amazing. Like, as I said, like, I have found myself in a privileged and lucky position that we do have a club doctor that, if I was to feel any difference in my chest, or if I was having any concerns, I've got a club doctor on hand that could check me over, that I could phone up at the drop of a hat, and he'll answer the phone to me and explain things to me. And like I said, speaking instead of me trying to figure out medically what might be going on in my chest, or why am I feeling like this, because I said I could come up with a million and one answers. But when you have someone like a doctor medically trained that can turn around and tell you are okay, you are fine, it does give you that reassurance that I honestly think you do need. Because as I said, if I was to try and think what was wrong with me or what's going on in my own mind, I wouldn't be able to answer my own questions.
Has it surprised you that you felt like this? Because I know that obviously when you play sports, you know, you get to exercise, see your friends. Did it surprise you when they said it's nothing wrong with your heart, and you realised it was probably mentally you were struggling a little bit?
That's when I kind of hit home, that mentally I was struggling, because it happened a couple of times, and I obviously thought it has to be the valve. If I was getting little twinges in my chest, it has to be the valve. If anything was happening to me, it had to be the valve. If I was walking up a flight of stairs and felt tired, it has to be because my heart's not right. And I was finding that I was questioning doctors telling me I'm fine, because I was thinking, I can't be getting these palpitations or these panics for no reason. There has to be a reason for it. And then one doctor would say, no, everything is fine. And then another doctor would come in and talk to me and say, no, everything's fine. And then another doctor would have to come and reassure me again. And I remember I sat in the hospital and I got really upset, because I started saying, well, how many doctors do I need to tell me everything's okay for me to start believing them? So then that's when I kind of understood mentally I am struggling. And it's something that at the beginning I thought, maybe I'm going mad in the head. Like, why am I feeling like this? I'm not thinking any negative thoughts. But then the more people I spoke to about the feelings I was having, or the anxieties I was having, it's becoming so much easier and so much better to handle, that I am coping with it so much better, and I am dealing with things a hell of a lot better. So if I do get a slight panic, I know what it is and I can relax myself, where the panic doesn't increase, where it gets out of control. And like I said, the first time put me in hospital. So like I said, I think speaking about it is something that I'm very big on.
I was going to ask you that, you know, in social media and social campaigns about mental health, it's, you know, talk to someone, which seems such a simple thing, but for you, that really has worked.
Yeah, for me, it really has worked, and that's something that for the last 10 years of my life playing football, I've never had to do, because I've always had football as that to take my mind off things. I've had it as a distraction. I've had training and seeing the lads every day as a distraction. But now I haven't got that distraction, and it seems as though at the beginning, like I said, I didn't know what was going wrong with me. I didn't know what this feeling was. And now that I do understand what the feeling is, and now when I do have questions to ask, I found as though I shouldn't be embarrassed to ask the simplest of questions of, could you just check this for me? Or what should I be feeling like this? Or should my heart rate be this? And probably the simplest of questions where, like I've said it to our doctor, Daniel Vaughan, so many times. I spoke with him and I said, like, I know I'm probably doing your head in asking all these questions, but I said, it's the small reassurances that are kind of keeping me relaxed. And I said, in time, they are getting better where I don't ask them as much and I don't say as much because I feel as though I'm handling it quite well. But from the beginning, it's been a massive help for me. And I think that if people do need to talk to people, I know, like I say, it's easier said than done at the beginning. I never spoke to anyone because, like I said, I had football as a distraction. But now, when I find myself in these little dark times and not understanding what's happening to myself, I find asking the questions and finding out that you're not on your own and you're okay for feeling like that makes me feel so much better.
You've said that you've spoken to some of your good friends at home, and you've been almost surprised that they've said they felt something similar, but also you've almost really been glad of that as well.
Yeah, like I remember when I was in the hospital after the first time I had that panic attack, I sat and spoke with my friend on the phone and I told him everything. I said, like, I'm in hospital now, and he was saying, is everything all right because of the operation? He wanted to know. And I said, everything's fine, but I said, I everyone's telling me I'm having a panic attack, and I said, I don't know if I am or not. I said, it has to be the valve, because I didn't understand what I might have been. And he started diagnosing me without me telling him what my symptoms were. So then that's how I kind of was like, oh, so you do understand what I'm going through, or you do understand it, which me and him sat and we spoke for an hour or two on the phone. And him saying everything, you will find like how to handle it, and if things do get better. He said, oh, I had to suffer with it for a while, and I did get better in time, and everything got better. And that, even from a friend back home that I've known my whole life, to not understand that he was having that, to know that, like, I have him to speak to now, as well as other people, it was like a massive, felt like a weight off my shoulders at the time.
Especially in football, there's a stereotype around, you know, players in their masculinity and maybe not talking as much. Do you think that maybe have been why you hadn't spoken about your mental health before?
I think, yeah, but then I also think, like, I was never the kind of person that, because of, like, the heart troubles I've had since I was 16, I've never looked for sympathy. I've never looked for people to give me the easy option and the easy route because of what I've had. So I never really, I used to always like to be the person to joke around and take my mind off things and have a joke and a laugh about things. But I think since the operation and since I don't have that distraction, I feel as though speaking is probably the best remedy that I've ever had. Like it's something where I could be sitting at home and I might turn around and say, oh, well, like this pandemic that's going on right now, it's crazy. And then, like I say, if I'm to sit there and think in my own head, like, do I feel this, do I feel that, or like, what did I do when I went outside? Then all of a sudden I start panicking myself, and it happens so easily and so quickly like that. Whereas now, when I sit there and talk about it, or when I've spoken to numerous of people at the club and speaking to people at home, it's something where it's felt like such a weight off my shoulders, where I feel as though it's helped me progress a lot better with the recovery than holding me back. Because I felt as though for a couple of weeks when I came out of hospital, I felt as I had nowhere to turn, and I felt as though I was being held back. But now when you know you're okay for feeling like this, like it's normal for after an operation like this to feel like this, that I can kind of accept it and go, well, do you know what, like, there will be ups and downs and there will be good days and bad days, but I know I'm okay. And that is the only thing that I've wanted to know since I came out of hospital, like, from since the operation. Once someone tells me I'm okay now, I said, that gives me any sort of energy to push on.
And there's also, like I said, a stigma around mental health anyway, you know, whether it's a man or a woman. Do you think that's lessening and actually you're seeing a turn and maybe people speaking about it a bit more?
Yeah, and I think that's due to when social media is being used in a positive way through Twitter, Instagrams and places like that. I think it's giving people a platform to be heard, whereas there could be some people that never want to leave their house. But if they've got a computer or a phone in front of them, they can write whatever they want on Twitter and people will start listening. And like I said, when social media is used on that, such a good platform, and you can get footballers on board and you can get athletes on board that they speak about their troubles as much, then people that are sitting in their homes can relate to people. And in the craziest way, me having this operation and the amount of people that I've spoken to through Twitter that have told me they've followed my career for the last 10 years and I don't know who they are, but I only get talking to them because they're telling me, oh, well, I've had some up and down days when I had my valve replacement, or some people telling me they're going in for a valve replacement and is there any tips I can give them, or how have you dealt with it? Or some people have told me that I was an inspiration for them because I went on and played professional football, where it made their recovery easier because they seen a professional footballer can do it, so they thought, why can't I do it? So, like, as I said, social media and places like that can be an amazing place, and it gives both men and women a chance to speak out. And it's good to see that men are talking more, because as you say, men aren't supposed to be these sensitive kind of people. They're meant to be people that bottle things up and be a protector of people, whereas men do need to talk. And like I said, I'm not afraid to say stuff now, and I'm not afraid to speak, because like I said, it's something that has helped me in a time where I feel as though I've needed it, whereas before I never thought I needed it.
And for someone watching now who's kind of feeling like you have felt, a message for them?
I think the simplest message is, as you've said from the beginning, is to talk, whether it's to a relative, whether it's to a random stranger, whether it's just to get stuff off your mind. I said, if you get that weight off your shoulders, whether, like I said, it could be to anybody and everybody, but when it's off your own shoulders and off your own mind, you'd be amazed how easy it is, or how much of a weight that bears on you until you speak about it. And I can only go off my experiences when I was letting my retirement build up on me without me realising. I was letting me not really having a full-time job build up on me since football. I was letting me panicking about my valve and about everything that was happening to me build up without speaking about it. And the minute I've spoken about it, I found everything becoming a lot easier and a lot better. Like, don't get me wrong, I still do struggle at times, but they're becoming less and less the more I talk. And like I said, if there's people out there that find it difficult to talk to their loved ones, well then phone up or speak to, as I said, speak to a stranger just to get it off your mind, because it will help you in the long run.
And for you, obviously, a real journey for you of the last 4 months, but light at the end of the tunnel for you a little bit.
Yeah, and that's down to obviously Newport sticking by me. They've been amazing, from the chairman to the manager when he was phoning me when I was in hospital, to the assistant manager Wayne Hatswell phoning me when I was in hospital. And it was his idea, because he heard about me struggling mentally, so he phoned me up and he said to me, would you not want to come in and get yourself busy, look at the analysis, and he said you can give your side of it as a player's perspective. And maybe that was a good gesture for him to just say, right, keep your mind busy. And like I said, I've been enjoying every single minute of it. The club have been amazing, asking me to help with the commentary, and I said I've been enjoying that. So I feel as though there's a purpose to me now, where I am enjoying it and I can go in and train and be around the lads again, and I'm still in a football environment, an environment that I've only ever known my whole life. And as I said, to have the club doctor like Daniel Vaughan, if I didn't have him here, then I'd probably be struggling that more. The reassurance he's given me, and like the times I call him and the times I text him, it's probably the most he spoke to me in the whole 3 years that I've been here. but I know I've needed him and he's been there. And like I said, I've just been lucky enough to have the people around me that I have, and to have like my mum who flew over for 3 months. I've had my girlfriend who was basically babysitting me for 3 months, but it's all for a bigger picture, and that's the only thing that I'm able to kind of put it to. And now I'm starting to see that bigger picture with progressing with fitness and progressing with some sort of career at different experiences that I'm getting, that now I can actually see that light at the end of the tunnel, and I feel proud of where I've been to where I am now. And I know it's not like the finished article, but I can actually see where I'm heading rather than before when I hadn't got a clue of anything.